Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there, in this video we're going to look at adding these sexy colors over here to InDesign. We'll look at color in general. It's a little bit long, this video, but it's the kind of stuff you need to know if you're going to be getting into kind of InDesign production. All right, so let's go and add some pre-made colors. Okay, before we go any further, let's just ensure your screen is looking like mine. So at the top here, go to Essentials. Okay, and if you'll say something else, it might say Advanced or something else, click up in this random area at the top here and click Essentials. I'm pretty sure on a PC it's over here as well. I remember in an earlier version it was all the way over here on the left. Double check. Okay, but find something that looks like that. Make sure it's on Essentials. And where it drops down, make sure you click on Reset Essentials as well. That means it just kind of gets it back to square one. This is handy for when you are, say, doing something and you accidentally drag this and it ends up in a weird spot down. Where's a weird spot? There it is there. And this bit goes there and everything's a bit mixed up. Okay, and you get a bit lost. So come back to this video and go to Essentials and go to Reset Essentials and everything kind of comes back to normal. What we'll also do for this course is see these double arrows here. I prefer to have this group of tabs always out rather than like little clickable in and out boxes. Okay, if you've got a really small screen, you might have to keep them all pushed in. So for the moment, let's ignore this little thing over here for the moment. That's something I've added for us later on. And what we're gonna do when we're starting a new job is we've created a new page, but one of the first things you should do now is create a new CC library, okay? So you might do CC libraries per client rather than per job, okay? So if you're working at one company, you might just have one. You can see on my libraries here, I got loads of them, okay? And all they are is a place to store things like, you can see in this case, colors, fonts, images. And the cool thing about it is that it's shared across all the Adobe products. You might be only using InDesign, but if you start using Photoshop or Illustrator, this library is in there as well, so you can share these colors across. So what we're going to do is CC libraries. We're going to use this little drop down. Yours is probably set to My Library. I've got a couple of My Libraries for some reason, but you've got one. Okay, I'm going to create a new library for this course. Okay, I'm going to call this one Green at Heart. Okay, you do the same. And let's click create. And it's just a nice empty library at the moment. But what it's gonna do is when we add our colors, we'll add them to the library at the same time. And when we bring in images and icons, they'll go in there as well. So to add colors, okay, we're gonna add corporate colors. Okay, if you are just playing around, you wanna mix up any color, watch this. If I highlight this text here and just go, what might happen is in this case, you can see here that nice little rainbow thing that was there a second ago is now this black and white. You can have switch it up here, okay, in this little fly up menu, back to RGB and you'll get that color thing back again. That happens quite a bit while you're working in InDesign. But if you've got no design at the moment and you're randomly picking colors for the client or yourself, you can just use this little eyedropper down here and just randomly pick colors, okay? And that might be great. But say we're working for a client that has specific color needs, so we're gonna have to put in their corporate colors. So let's go and do that now. One of the things we'll look at is swatches are pre-made colors, okay? Now, InDesign's giving you a couple of pre-made ones. There is none, so empty box. Okay, there's registration and reasonably complicated, but at our level here, just never ever use it. I never use registration. We'll look at it a little bit more in our advanced class. We'll look at registration and plates, okay? But just ignore that one for the moment. What you wanna do is use black, not registration. Okay, so black and then there's white. They call it paper because you'd imagine if you're printing, if I printed this, okay, and I was expecting this to be white, but I put blue paper in my printer, it's not gonna actually be white, is it? It's gonna be blue of the paper. So that's why they're all clever with the word paper there and not white, but it means white. Then they went and mixed in some really awful colors. Okay, these are there by default. You can delete them. You can select them all and say goodbye with the little trash can. Okay, we'll leave them there for the moment. So what we wanna do is mix our own colors. Now, you're gonna have to find out what your corporate colors are. Okay, so you might be working at a company and they've got a corporate manual, okay, and it lists out their colors. Okay, you might have to ask the marketing department what they are or the designer that was working there or working with you or, so you're gonna have to figure out what these colors are. Now to create a swatch, go into this little flyout menu here in the swatches panel, and there's one at the top here, it says new color swatch. And if it doesn't have anything, okay, sometimes I've been on my type tool and I've got text selected and it's freaking out a little bit. So what I can do is just go back to my arrow, okay, and I've clicked off in the background. Now I can go through and go new color swatch. I'll pretend like I did that on purpose to show you a lesson, but really just got lost. Let's click on this top one here, says name with color value. If you leave that on, you're gonna have colors like this, which aren't very useful, okay, the actual code for them, especially when you're dealing with a client, say like me. I've worked for hundreds of companies, so if I type in green, it could be green from any company. So I'm gonna untick this, and I'm working for the green at heart. Okay, and so I'm just putting the little acronym in there. If you're working for Disney, put in Disney green. I'm working with green at heart, red. Okay, and what we're gonna do is the color mode. Now we're gonna be using RGB in this class, okay? You might look at your corporate manual and they use CMYK. The times where you use each of them, RGB is probably the most common, okay? Especially if you're gonna be designing something that's gonna be viewed on a screen. So RGB is red, green, blue, and that's what your screen uses to display colors. CMYK is what your printer uses to display colors. And you'll notice it's a lot less, because if you've ever printed something from your laptop and it looks awesome, and then it prints out on the printer just a little bit washed out, it's because of CMYK. Okay, RGB luckily has a bigger color field. It also has light coming out of it, luminance, okay, because your laptop screen is all bright and it's got lights in it, so it can achieve those colors like the toxic green or like a Madonna pink at RGB. When you use CMYK is when you're going to a commercial printer or an offset printer, they call it. Okay, and that happens, depends on what you're working. If you're doing stuff and it's going to be printed in the office, send it RGB. Office printers love RGB. Even if they're laser color printers, they'll like RGB more. It's only if you're getting like 10,000 printed at a large printing house, they'll expect CMYK. Okay, they look very similar in terms of the colors, but the codes are slightly different. We're gonna use RGB, and here are the RGB colors that I've got. So we're gonna list all these out. So I'm gonna put in 255 for the first one, and 99, and then 88. Okay, and you see it's still at pink, but if I click out here, okay, one of the other ones, it changes to my swatch. Okay, and what I wanna do is I'm gonna add it to my library at the same time, green at heart. You might have a different one, okay, lots of different ones. Okay, but I'm gonna add it to my green at heart at the same time. If you're confused by libraries and you just hate them and you don't wanna use them, you can untick this. Let's click add rather than okay. Why? Just means it keeps this open, okay, so I can add more colors. This one's going to be green at heart and this one's gonna be the yellow. Okay, and add another one, 255. I'm tabbing down, we'll click in the next box, 145. Okay, click. Actually, don't click anything because it's pink, not yellow. I think I left the two off the front of this one. Okay, so ignore that note, it's over here. It should be 255, 255, 145. Okay, so I'm going to click add. You can see there it appears in my libraries. It also appears down here in my swatches, okay, and both places. So what I want you to do now is pause, okay, and go through and add these. I'm gonna get Taylor, our wonderful editor, to go through and speed this up. So I'm gonna insert mine. Okay, see you at the end, race ya. Okay, here we are, and when you're finished, I click add or click okay. Either way, it closes it down. Now we need to click okay, so it's finished. Now, a couple of things. You might have clicked okay by accident. How do you get back in there? Okay, you just go back into the flyout menu and say new color swatch. If, like me, you've spelt one wrong, okay, I've left the green off it, you can just double click it, okay, and it opens up, and put my N in, click okay. If you forgot to tick the box at the bottom, you can select on these guys and see this little cloud kind of icon here. This will add it to the swatches over here. All right, so that's the end of this super duper long color nerd fest. I realize we're a bit into this course and we still just have a blank page, but that's okay. Okay, so that's it for this video. We're gonna move on to stealing colors from logos. Just in case you don't know what the corporate spec is, I'm gonna show you a sneaky trick to go and do that. So let's go do that in the next video. So, what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off, stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.